smoke, breathe me in and let me go. Sing to your heart to find you.
Hello, my lovelies, this is Simspell, and welcome to episode 51 of The Sims 4 Vampire Amazon series, Generation 2. Before we start off this episode, I just want to let you guys know that part 3 of Morgana's Memories is now out on my website. I will leave a link in the description down below, so if you guys want to go have a read, you can do that. It basically explores Morgana's childhood in depth and goes into detail about moments that we either missed or we did not even look at. So I think that'll be quite exciting for those of you, especially for any of you who are excited about Morgana's bloodline and the devils and what happened to Amanda and all those crazy things. And also the fact that Morgana's about to have a baby soon and continue the bloodline. If you guys want to know more about her and how she grew up, you can go and check that story out. So let's get started with the actual episode. Isn't Freya adorable? She's so flippin' cute, I've got to say. I think Callio over here was trying to give her a hug, and she was like, no, I don't want it. I don't want it. That's so cute. But anyways, I went ahead and set up a little bit more in this area where Ursula is about to have her birthday, or her womaning. There we go. And I've put down some of these really cool decorative items, the armadillos. I think that was really nice. And I just put a crazy amount of lantern lights here to light up the area, but also I was trying to go for a theme that Ursula had, and I'm thinking we're going to do this for every, like, womaning we have from now on. We're actually going to build this whole thing over here every time a child ages up into a teenager. And we're going to try and use lanterns that kind of go with the color scheme that they've had as a child. For Ursula, for example, she wears mint, and she loved the color mint throughout her childhood. So I went ahead and made sure these lanterns were minty colored. Of the ones that I had the choices between, these came with the pink, blue, and yellow, which I think looks fine. And then just having these really cool, garlands and stuff around the place. I think that looks really nice. Ah, it's gonna light up the area well. Nice photo op. And also, I feel like it centers the space a lot more. So this is where we're gonna have the celebrations. Before that, however, we actually need to go ahead and feed the ladies. So Lady Clara is going to start a gathering. Actually, no, I think the Queen's gonna start a gathering because, she's the one who I think threw the party for Ursula. So I think she is gonna be in, like, half in her mind to go ahead and be the one to call her a blood banquet over. So there we go, and then all the ladies are going to feed. Once they have fed, then we'll gather around the table and have Ursula age up and then see how she looks. And I know some of you lovelies... Oh, by the way, I'm so sorry for naming the previous episode the Ritual of Fire. I know some of you lovelies freaked out because you thought it was the Fire Tribute. We were at episode 50. But don't worry, it wasn't the Fire Tribute. Nobody's about to die, as far as I know. Nobody's dying. It's okay. I have not any planned deaths in the near future. So you're fine. You're fine. Okay. Queenie, these ladies are outside. Do you guys want to come inside? Okay, once they start coming in, then we'll start feeding on them. But you guys might be happy or even frustrated to know we're around halfway through this generation, so just because we've reached episode 50 doesn't mean anything. It does not mean that we are near the end in any way, shape, or form. Because, again, the episodes, I do realize season 1 was 49 episodes. It was supposed to be 50, but there's 50 episodes, but there's 49 in the playlist because I accidentally deleted one of the episodes. But that was 50 episodes. Doesn't mean season 2 is going to be 50 episodes, because season 1, each episode was around 40 minutes long, whereas in season 2, or generation 2, our episodes are 20 minutes long. So we're not covering as much in each episode as we did in the previous season. Therefore, we're not even halfway through. So don't worry, we have a long, long way to go. Long way to go before we reach that. But okay, are you going to start drinking? Mm-hmm. Yep, we've got the Queen going over, compelling someone to drink. Clara, you need to get someone as well. Oh, look, there's someone in the kitchen just for you. So we're going to get her to drink plasma. And then We'll get Morgana to come this way. Morgana, drink plasma. She's really thirsty. So plasma and then Lady Kennedy. Let's see. Is there anyone around the place? Kennedy, yeah, you're thirsty, but this is not where you're supposed to be drinking. Okay, let's see. Is anyone else around the place? I don't know who's taken and who's not. I think this one's taken by the queen. Yes, she is. Someone's taken by Lady Clara. Clara, no. Stop talking to this guy. You need to be drinking. Let's drink, drink, drink. Come on, let's drink. Is she going to drink yet? Morgana has already locked onto someone, and so has the queen. Actually, no, the queen hasn't. Queenie, what happened? I sent someone to you. Where did she go? I know you want to talk to your daughter, but... Okay, it seems as though I think this chick just walked away because the queen was occupied with something else. Not command. We need a deep drink. This is one of the pains of playing with autonomy. I have to stick with each one of my vampiruses and make sure that they go ahead and actually feed on someone. Otherwise, they don't feed and then they start getting hungry. And nothing, no instinct in their body compels them to go ahead and have a drink. So let's go get yourself a drink. Once they start transforming, then I know they're gonna carry out the rest of the interaction, but I need to make sure that they even go ahead and do that, so. Come on, let's drink up, let's drink up. The party's about to end. We're gonna have to throw another party for this birthday, because this isn't gonna work out. Are you gonna drink her? Yes, no, yes, no. What's happening? What's happening? Genevieve, stop it, Genevieve. Your mother's trying to have a drink. Okay. Clara has had a drink, so has Morgana. Now we have Kennedy left. Okay, Kennedy, let's go hunting for someone. Do you have anyone around here? I don't see anyone. Yeah, I don't see anyone around the place. Maybe they're upstairs? Nope, I don't see anyone upstairs either. No one all the way up here except for Ursula. Down in the dungeon. Nope, not really. Okay, well, did someone miss out on a drink then? Because it seems as though not all the ladies arrived. Unless, Goldfruit 3. Oh yeah, we have Goldfruit 3. So go drink from her. Kennedy's the last one left. Once she's done, we're just gonna throw another party, guys. We can say it was one long party. This was the feast. The blood banquet. This was just the blood banquet. And then we're going to have the actual womaning ceremony in a little bit. And Morgana, look at this, guys. Morgana is in her third trimester, so any episode now, she should be having her offspring, and hopefully it is a girl. Hopefully. I know some of you lovelies left suggestions about what we could do with this area, and you asked if I had thought about having a greenhouse. And actually, I have not thought about a greenhouse because I was supposed to, like, this indoor garden was supposed to kind of be like a greenhouse, although it's very tiny, and so I said that we would convert this area into a bigger garden for Morgana, which I think we're probably going to do at some point. And so that's kind of going to function like a greenhouse. And because of that, I didn't want to have a separate greenhouse because... You know, we don't have, yeah, that's a lot of space, but we don't have a whole heap of space, especially if we need to build things for story purposes, and so I don't want to waste items or anything on stuff that we don't necessarily need or we already have. Like, multiples of something isn't the way that I want to go about things. And you guys gave an awesome idea and said we should have Morgana's daughter, if she has a daughter, be a botanist or something, or include a new role. And that does sound really awesome, but the thing about the way I play my priestess role is that they're supposed to do both ritual stuff and also botany. So the priestesses, in a sense, are botanists. It's part of their role. Otherwise, we're not always doing rituals, and if we don't have rituals to do, they're going to have nothing to do. They're just going to be a husk, an empty role that doesn't do anything. So, for that reason, when they're not participating in ritual and religious practice, I make sure that they're looking after the gardens and all of those sort of things. So, I hope that is okay with you guys. But everyone's had a drink now, about, yes? Okay, wonderful, everyone's had a drink. So the queen is going to throw the official party. Let's plan a social event. Let's go, let's go. And then I'm going to turn autonomy off, and oh my goodness, the queen's about to stink. No, queen, you can't do this. Okay, house party, yes. Host all of the ladies. And then guests, we have Ursula, Calliope, Ophelia, Persephone, Anna Rose, Genevieve, Freya, and that's about it. So I'll invite all of them again. We'll have a caterer, yes. Yes, yes, yes. For the children, not for anyone else. It's mainly for just the children. So we've got that going on with these ladies. Okay. You, my darling, can have a quick bath. I'm going to get Ursula to just have a quick bath so that her hygiene is up and good. And the queen needs a quick bath. So the queen is actually going to rush up. Yeah, the queen's going to rush up, take a quick bath. Kennedy, do you need a bath? No. Kennedy's okay. We're waiting on the queen now. As soon as the queen's done, we're going to rush on down and we're going to get Ursula to age up. So, okay, let's go, let's go. Have your bath, super quick, thank you very much. I don't want to spend too much time on this. Okay, she doesn't use her bathroom a lot. It's a very luxurious bathroom. She should use it more often. And is she almost done? Ursula's done. And yeah, they're feeling quite sad. Everyone's feeling quite gloomy, but I think we should be okay pretty soon. It is 8 p.m. I don't want to kind of encroach too long and have Ursula age up on her own. Okay, now I'm going to do turning off autonomy, the difficult thing. Turn off autonomy, and then I'm going to just assemble everyone downstairs in the banquet hall so they can attend this gathering. Okay, let's have everyone show up over here. Wonderful, fly as a bat. Morgana's going to show up. Clara's going to show up. Wonderful. Everyone's going to make it down. Said they're attending. Oh, this is going to be exciting. This is going to be so exciting. Okay. How's everyone going? Everyone's down here? Clara's not having fun at all. Okay, Ursula, come on down. Come on down, honey. Okay, Ursula's going to come on down. She's really hungry. Don't worry. You can get your cake. You'll get your cake pretty soon. Let's rush, rush, rush. Normally I wouldn't rush them, but I do want to get a move on. Come on. Where'd she go? Even Freya's coming over here. There we go. Okay, she's making her way down, and oh my goodness, it is storming so bad. Okay, it is storming like crazy. But let's get Ursula to blow out the candles. Oh, this is so exciting. No, get rid of that umbrella. Get rid of the atrocious umbrella. Oh, no. No, no. No, no. Get rid of that atrocious umbrella. Stop holding the umbrella. Oh, that's so irritating when they do that. I just wish that'd stop. There we go. And can you come right in the middle? I want her to go to the middle because I want her to blow out the candles from the middle. Okay, come on, let's go. I guess if she wants to go off to the side, that's fine too. Okay, and here she goes, guys. Here she goes. Oh, she looks so cute. I need to get the photo op. Photo op. Okay, look at her. She looks so adorable. I love this. She's so cute. Hold on a second. Hold on a second, guys. There we go. This is precious. So precious. Oh, she's so cute. She's so adorable. Oh, she's so adorable. Okay, well, I think this is okay. We got quite a few. And let's just watch her age up, shall we? Here she goes, guys. Here she goes. Oh, my goodness. Oh, she's aged up. Oh, she looks pretty. Okay, hold on a second. So we get to decide what trait she has. And I think the way I play it, and I do forget because it's been a while since we had this, but I think the child trait they randomize when they age up in the creature cradle, and then I choose their other traits. I'm assuming that's the way we play it. Now, what do I want her to have? Now, I don't remember everything, but I think that Persephone is paranoid. I don't exactly know entirely, but I think she's paranoid. I think Ursula is going to grow up very self-absorbed. I don't know if you guys see that, but I see that. I see her being very self-absorbed. So I'm going to give her that trait, and she's also going to get athletic because she is a warrior and that's what she wants to do and she has to do. So there we go. Let's have a look at her. Oh, wow. Okay, this is Ursula. Doesn't she look so much? Holy cow. She looks so much like her mother. That is crazy. She looks a lot like Cynthia. Holy cow. That is very, very weird. She looks a lot like Cynthia, which is pretty cool. But guys, I'm going to go ahead. Is this her everyday wear? I don't know. I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to give her a makeover, and then I'm going to show you guys what she looks like in a bit. So, see you guys in a second. Okay, we are finally back. It took me 2 hours to make over Cynthia. I had to go CC shopping because I realized we didn't have anything appropriate for her. We went through everything I had previously brought. Everything I had previously CC shopped, I had used up. So I needed to clear those out, and then I had to go get some dresses for her and update the royal wardrobe pretty much. That doesn't mean I gave everyone a makeover, of course, but as part of it, I do like to filter through some of the stuff that the previous members have used. Anyways, this is Cynthia over here. So I went ahead and changed her hair color back to black because she did grow up with black hair. She did not have the auburn sort of hair color that her mother did. But this is her. She looks really cool. Her theme is pretty much black, mustard yellow, white in some places, largely mustard yellow. And this is the dress she has. Let me know what you guys think. I think she looks so pretty. You know what? To be honest, Ursula. Did I just say Cynthia? I've been calling her Cynthia for the past 5 minutes. I mean Ursula. I apologize, everyone. Ursula Ronarain. This is Ursula. She finally got her tattoo, and that is the Ronarain tattoo, if I am not wrong. I'm hoping I'm not. I couldn't remember exactly what it looked like, but I think that was the one. So I went ahead and gave her that, except inked in black. I'm pretty sure her mother had it inked in brown or something. But this is the dress all the way around, and this is also her hair. Lovely, black, very nice. Half up, half down. I think that looks really nice on her. And her makeover is actually quite simple. Again, with the teenagers, I don't like giving them any makeup so that we can see their natural features. Look at that. Isn't she beautiful? She looks so much like Cynthia and Kali is what I was trying to say before I lost track of what was happening. But there we go. Let me know what you guys think down in the comments below. So I will show you guys her dark form in a bit, but as for the rest of her outfits, as I said, it follows in this theme. I think it looks pretty cool. I'm very, very happy with what she ended up with. And then if we change to her dark form, let's go ahead and quickly have a look. There we go. Her interactions, some of them are going to be a little bit weird with the arms because of the dress. It is definitely the dress causing those things. But I'm sure I'll be able to work around it. But this is what she looks like in her dark form. I think she looks very nice. She's got really pale skin, white eyes or pupils, and then she's got these really nice, like a dusty purple-pink sort of hair, and I like it. It looks pretty cool. Let me know what you guys think down in the comments below. But there we go. That is our lovely Cynthia. She can change back. Change back. And why don't you put on your party wear, my darling? So she is going to put on her party wear. There we go. Doesn't she look fabulous? And I think with that said and done, actually, before I do anything else, before we wrap up super quick, I want to show you guys Morgana's makeover because, yes, Morgana got another makeover. The reason for that is because when I was doing CC shopping, I cleared a bunch of old stuff that we had for Generation 1 members and stuff. And part, oh, geez, the cake's off. Great. Well, part of that, Morgana lost her dress and some of her outfits. So I went ahead and just gave her a total makeover. So let me show you guys what she looks like. Hold on a second. Oh no, we don't want to ask the baby's due date. Come on. We're going to change her. And this is what she looks like in her new makeover. Let me know what you guys think. Let me just reset so you guys can see. Let me know what you think. This was one of the new dresses that I got. And her makeup is kind of softer but more extreme at the same time. Her horns are now black instead of red. And this is what she looks like all the way around. And in her dark form, she looks... Hold on a second. Let's change. I want to show everyone your dark form. Here she goes. There we go. This is her in her dark form. So let me know what you guys think down in the comments below about the makeovers of these two lovely ladies. And I'll see you all in the next episode. Bye-bye. As the celebrations for Ursula's womaning came to a close, the vampiruses dispersed throughout the castle to resume their various tasks and assignments. Everyone kept mistaking Ursula for Cynthia. Luckily, the newest members, Clara and Kennedy, were there to correct the others who had been around during Cynthia's time. Lady Morgana was heavily pregnant, and there was a nervous excitement among the ladies for the baby's arrival. The priestess was keeping herself distracted with research and other botanical studies. She had some ideas for expansion which she wanted to discuss with the queen at some stage. Once there was a proper plan in place, she would make a proposal. Lady Kennedy was having trouble being idle after the rapid succession of her duties when she had first arrived. She wasn't used to having nothing to chase after and investigate. Often, her feet would take her into the children's quarters, where she would look absently at the toys. Sometimes, she was almost tempted to cause trouble so that she would have something to do. Ursula, on the other hand, had plenty to occupy her time with. There were a lot of things about her family that had intrigued her as a child, but she was too young to pursue. Now a woman, she could do almost everything she wanted. The first matter of business concerned Castle Sheba. All she needed was the Queen's permission.